Hey guys, Jared Beckstrand here, physical therapist, owner, founder of toneandtitan.com. And today I wanted to answer a question that I get asked all the time in my physical therapy clinic. Should I put heat or ice on an injury? Now, we all know that these thermal modalities are good for an injury or for a body area that hurts. However, sometimes it's hard to tell which one should I use. So today, that's the question that I wanted to answer. Now, in order to answer this question, we need to understand a little bit of the physiology of both. We're going to start with heat. Now, heat is a vasodilator. Simply put, what that means is that it opens up all of your capillaries. It promotes blood flow into an area. That being said, I'll typically reach for heat in patients that are sore, stiff, kind of a dull ache type of a feeling. I love heat for lower back injuries. I love heat for neck injuries. This is, you know, you kind of wake up in the morning, it's stiff, it's sore, reach for your heating pad for that. Those are the types of injuries that I love for heat. Again, a vasodilator, we're going to promote blood flow into an area. Ice, on the other hand, is going to be what we call a vasoconstrictor. What that means is that it constricts your capillaries, that it actually restricts blood flow into an area. Now, with that vasoconstriction, it's also a great way to get rid of inflammation. So whenever we think of inflammation, when we think of anti-inflammatory, I think ice. Also, with that vasoconstriction, it's a great way to get rid of edema. So if you've got swelling in an injury, that's another great chance to reach for ice. There's also an analgesic effect to ice. It's a great way to slow down nerve conduction velocity. Simply means that the pain isn't quite as bad if there's ice on that area. I mean, if it's numb, if you can't feel anything, you can't feel pain, right? And so those are the three things. So anti-inflammation, anti-edema, and anti-pain. Ice, I'll typically reach for ice in an acute injury. So I mean, if you know, you're out, I don't know, doing yard work or any activity in the gym or lifting weights, and you feel pretty sore afterwards, I'll typically reach for ice with that. Again, an acute injury, something that's lasted less than like 2 or 3 days, I love ice for that. If it's more than like a week or two, if it's kind of that stiff, sore, achy kind of feeling, I'll typically reach for heat with that. A good rule of thumb to follow is that you want to leave those on, heat or ice, for about 20 minutes on and about 20 minutes off. 20 minutes, that's about as long as the therapeutic effect as you'll get out of that ice pack, especially as it starts to cool down. Heat, you don't necessarily need to leave it on there too much longer than that. But then again, it's that 20 minute off period that kind of allows your tissue temperature to regulate and to kind of get back to normal. Now, it's important to remember that these are the textbook answers. This should happen with most people, most of the time, these effects as I've just explained them. However, what I usually recommend to people is, I'll just try both. You might respond better to heat, you might respond better to ice. Try them both out, see which one you like better. 20 minutes on, 20 minutes off, about 3 times a day is typically what I recommend to people. Hopefully your injury starts to feel better with those guidelines. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you found this useful. I hope you found it informative. If you did, go ahead and leave it a thumbs up. Thanks so much for those in advance. While you're here, it's also a great chance to subscribe to Tone and Titan. I share a lot of great rehab advice, some great workouts, some great healthy recipes. My goal is to help you to achieve your fitness goals. I hope that you subscribe to Tone and Titan. Also, if you have a question or a comment about anything that I've discussed, go ahead and leave it down in a comment below. Also, a great chance, if there's any questions that you guys have about other things that I can answer for you, I'll be sure to get to those as well. So again, thanks so much for watching here on Tone and Titan, and we'll see you next time.